Okay, let's get started. I'm gonna be sharing things on social now to make sure everyone sees this. Well, yeah, so let's get started. The last Sunday we were exploring some redesigns for the project view at Otter, and let's see, I don't even remember right now where we left it, so... this is all part of a huge kind of design exploration that I want to do. And I guess I'm just starting with the... let's say like the most painful point in the... in the project right now, and this is kind of like for setting the baseline for some features that they want to build for it. Right now there's like some things that, I don't know, like when a customer makes an order, they don't have a way to edit it, so they come back to us sometimes asking for us to add like some extra files to a project, right, like all these attachments and everything. So making that editable will be great for them, so that people can always have like extra attachments to a project. And there's in here some extra information that we haven't yet added, right? Like on master we have a summary of the chat that you can visit in this URL, that it's also pending for a redesign, right? Like, all this, there's like so much wasted white space, even like the color, the style, everything looks like very bland. There's repeated information that doesn't make any sense. All that, right? But I think, whereas I did like some streaming session already exploring that chat redesign, and I think there's many things that I know that I think we can do in there. I guess exploring it from this sort of high level view could make sense as well. So yeah, I'm going to read a little bit what we have in here. So all this is the previous like project view, like the things that are commented out. So I'm thinking that even maybe I can just like keep this in a different page right now so that we can compare things quickly. And for that, I think we can make here another page that's kind of like, we're going to call it old. And I think if I just like remove the new project component and add the old one, let's see if this works. Maybe I did remove some, yeah, I removed some stuff as well in here. Yeah. Okay, so this is more or less the same. Yeah. So this was like the old view, more or less, the one that's currently in production, right? And that I've shown you in other streams. Whereas this is the new design that I'm aiming for, a single column layout and kind of putting the information with like in its proper place. So let's continue. We have like files in here that usually, well, these were added as a summary of the files that have been both attached from the customer and within the chat. I think it makes sense in here to separate it to be like a different module, like the summary of files, maybe even building like a file gallery of sorts. And then like the chat summary, as well as for projects that have a budget. We're showing them like this, and I want to give them like a proper entity to them, like maybe making each of them a different card and kind of giving the state or showing all of them. Right now I'm showing only the ones that are accepted. I think it makes sense to show the ones that are rejected as well and the ones that are pending, because right now the customer needs to go to the chat, to the actual banner, to see the budget, to check it out. And I would love to lower the friction that's currently around like budget management. So I'm thinking that maybe we can tackle that one first, because I think it's also one of the most like important pieces here to show as soon as possible. And I'm going to keep over here another browser window with documentation for both Chakra UI and Tailwind, since I'm using the Tailwind UI components as a guide for explaining all this. For designing all this, for like making all this like more manageable. And I think I'm getting like the budgets from the project itself. No, or oh, there's none. Okay, here we have two budgets, right? And so I'm going to change the query right now. I'm going to clean up the imports. And I want all the budgets, right? So I'm going to remove the where clause here. And this, oh wow, this gives me 21 budgets to manage. So it's interesting, not a very realistic case. So I think maybe I can even like just get rid of some of them or test with a different project. Right now, maybe I can add like one single budget to this one. And this is kind of like the model for which like the carpenter can add a budget, right? And I can say like, well, this is worth this amount in euros. This is a test budget pending of acceptance. And you can just like touch file. I'm going to just like get one image from Unsplash. This can be a PDF or whatever. This is the way it displays right now in the chat, right? And the client can see, actually, maybe you can. Maybe you can show you in an incognito window. That the client can either accept or reject the budget. If they reject it, they can share why, which is great for the carpenter to know. So I would love to put this into this view. So I'm going to try to map the budget to a React component that I think I might grab something similar to to this one in here. So see, like now we have like all these budgets this takes like too much space. If I was to put them here, in kind of one per line. So I will try to make it first, I don't know, like to play around with design, with the content that we have. And yeah, and see what. Because it feels like I have like these fields, the quantity, the description, an attachment, and a delivery date. Many of them are optional right now, which I will try to change as well. I think it's delivery date, let's see. No. Ah, just date. So this is great because it will allow me to, yeah, just like to try and see how it looks with different data, because like there's so many optional attributes right now. So I can add the quantity. What else? The attachment and the delivery date. So thank you. And I need to only render this if there's an attachment, of course. Budget.attachment name. And the make sure that the optional things remain hidden if they are not specified. It's really like, it's only mandatory right now the quantity, so. Okay, and this is okay, but we can see how this is like too much. There's budgets that take like a longer description that I've seen. And I'm actually going to clean up some of these budgets, just to disconnect them from the project, because they don't make that much sense. Okay. So now we have way less budget. Okay, that's fine. That's great. I'm going to grab the first one and put in like a longer description. Okay, so this is what I meant, right? And this is kind of like the way it feels right now. So this should be like two columns, really. And I wonder if instead of adding the file like this, it should be kind of in the footer to show some sort of, yeah, just like a link in there, like download details or something like that, right? So let's play with that. That way the elements will look more like this. Like this. But it feels like it's a more like cohesive experience, I guess. So I guess if I wanted to build footer and then in here I put this link instead of the attachment name, which feels weird. Something like C attachment. I think a copy like that could make sense. Again, this is if there's like a budget attachment. Okay, not bad. And there's, I think, like the idea of footer, it's also, it makes a lot of sense because you should be able to add like more or to have more actions in here, right? Like you should be able to accept or reject a budget. And I guess that for that, let's see. First of all, I'm going to make this size smaller for the attachment. And then in here, in this other side, I can add So actually, I'm going to make this an inline like. An inline stack, or yeah, just like a flex container. And let's put like an accept and reject button, and the reject one with more like a link feel to it. And let's make sure that they are always aligned to the right, and that they are like a smaller size as well. I think there's like a size prop to it. Okay, and if we align the items in the footer, great. Let's make them ghost. So this is cool, and I don't know, with this built this way, I know I have the feeling if I should be able to to make this just like like way smaller, right? Like it feels like they can be just cards like this. Oh, also something that I just realized. Well, no, let's fix this first. I think it makes sense maybe to put all of them in a grid. I don't know if I will be able to compose things. I don't know if this just looks like too weird right now. It got stuck, the whole build process. Yeah. Let's change the bit in the meantime. Let's put something like more for hackers. I mean, the spacing looks good between these cards, but at the same time, it's like, I don't know. Doesn't feel that great. I mean, the width, definitely it's much better this way. I think it makes a much more sense than having like the full width that we had before. But no, I don't know. There must be another way to handle this. Now, let's try again with a grid, but more with a custom grid setup. Where was that guide with examples for different grids? Trying to remember. I mean, if it's this way, then if I was like to sort them differently, I mean, this is not that bad. Then I just need to make sure that this is, it's always lined the way it should. I wonder if with something like this I would make sure of that, and I guess like that means that can these cards be Oh, fuck. No, why is this happening? I see. What to do here? Okay, this would be great. This would be great, but I guess this is forcing me to actually turn this into its own TV into its own component. That way I can create kind of like a card with a header, like although, and in here you can have like a card header that's like this. And so I can just like compose these things together. Now I should be able to define the 100% height, not width. Okay, and things are properly aligned. I mean, I want to force in a way for people to start adding some more context rather than these other items in here that are like, well, this item especially, that doesn't tell you anything. So we will look into a way for making some of those fields required and providing the much better feedback for carpenters, because I want to make it easy for them anyway. I guess like I'm just doing all these things as well to just to make things easier than they are right now. And there's so much back and forth for so many things that, yeah, not great. But yeah, this is looking much better. We are lacking some things still. The budget has a state, right? It can be accepted or rejected. It's a boolean. By default, I think it's just like undefined or null. So you can see if it's pending of acceptance or if it's accepted or rejected, just with the same flag. And so here we just want to render the stack. If budget is acceptance, it's null. And I'm missing an AND operator. That's weird. I'm going to check here. All the budgets were actually. No. All the budgets were the project, it's this one. Okay, all of them are pending of interaction, so that's great. So I guess we can add here, I think on the header it would be great to have like some sort of badge right now, like a new, yeah, something like that, right? Like, hey, this is new, you need to pay attention to this, right? You haven't taken action. And of course, we need also to limit this for clients, right? Like the carpenter shouldn't be the one that accepts their own budget. But so the if budget is not accepted or rejected, let's add batch. And we can make then the card header. Oh, it's so hot in here. My God. Hopefully the microphone doesn't pick that much the noise from the fan. But I need something. Okay, what happened here? Why this space between flex direction row? Oh, it's the size. This always trips me up. I thought there was like a size to it, I guess. I can pass props for box, so maybe I can... then pass like some some different font sizes. And I think for the responsive style, I just want to make them one column. Which for that, I think it's just like a matter of adding the min max I have on the main grid, right? Okay, that's something that needs to change. Oh. Am I missing something? I feel it must be like the third stream I do that I go to check again this link in my newsletter for this CSS grid tip, but I think it's for this case. Okay, this is more like it. %40. Nah, the minimum should be... Okay. Okay. Yes. Okay, great. The font size didn't affect this element, right? Okay, so the budgets look much better now. Definitely better than the old version. Right? No one can read this. This is perfect. And yeah, let's see if we can change this quickly on mobile, right? Like, it doesn't feel that great to have. I don't know if I can add responsive styles to this. I don't think so. Nah, this doesn't work. Okay. not bad. We just need some padding overall because this looks hideous. I think if I add like some padding like that, should be enough. Wait, why is this? Yeah, I'm not sure what should be the what should be the minimum here. I can't define something that's like too big, right? So you should be able to put here like 100%, right? No, sorry, here. Yeah, maybe it's just like to keep it on the smallest size. Thank you. Okay. This is cool. Wait, what? What happened here? Suddenly everything's breaking. Let's go back 1 second. Did I mess up with somebody so badly? Can't remove all these. Okay, this was working before. Okay, so I don't know what I did. I don't care. Don't tell me. Let's make this smaller. And let's make this a nicer and clearer color. Put it together. Okay, so this is cool. Cool. Now, yeah, maybe it's time to refactor this. Ah, no. I'm gonna do it manually. Okay, so I think let's see, budget, this should duplicate things in the page if I have my any mistakes which I've made. Okay, so let's delete the whole thing. This is one of the things that I picked up many years ago when refactoring, which is like to make sure that you're not breaking things. So don't cut and paste things away. The goal is that at any given moment in time, you're not breaking the build, right? And this is kind of like, there's like these micro moves that you can apply, like what I've done, right? Like duplicating first, creating the abstraction, and then adding this extra thing, saying that it's double, that it's working the same way it is. If you don't have any tests, like I don't have right now for the UI. So it's a great way to just like move with confidence and fast, really. So now with this, I'm happy to move things into a different file. I'm thinking like the UI components one that I have for the project. I can move this client UI components project. Budget grid. No, yeah, I'm breaking things now. We are back. This should be much cleaner now. And we can start removing unused constants. Okay, so now the budget has like some extra behavior, right? Like the actual budget card. I should be able to accept or reject a budget. We've already seen that, right? Like, these buttons don't do anything right now. But I'm exposing in my... in my GraphQL API, I'm exposing this to mutations for accepting or rejecting a budget. That you just need to pass, like, the budget ID and the reason if you're rejecting it, so we can take a look at how to implement it from scratch for this case and how it will change as well. Things like the new one will be something else, right? Like accepted or something like this. So I think we can start just like with the accept budget one. So we can just use mutation hook for that. In here I just want to do like, yeah. For now, I'm just going to create the mutation here. So mutation accept budget takes an ID. Type ID and runs like accept budget. And it just returns a boolean, right? So that's all I need to do here. Great, so this should also change some state to loading, right? Because I want to be able to show, yeah, just like a tiny like loading interaction whenever that change is happening. And I will want to also refetch the whole like project information so that it updates the whole page, but that's something that we can do as another iteration. So in here I just want to pass a variable. First of all, I'm going to set the loading state to true and at the end to false. And here I'm going to run like my action mutation. And I'm going to disable just like put a disabled unloading state when running the mutation. And so I want to accept the budget with the variable being like ID, and it needs to be the budget ID. So I need to receive this, which I'm not sure if I'm receiving it right now. So we need to go and check the query for the project. Yeah, we're receiving it, so this should work. And actually, let's try this as well. Refetch queries should be an object with the query get project, and I need as a variable the project ID, right? Get project, it's getting a project variable. So for now I'm going to get it from the router because I know I'm loading it from this page. I think I will specify it differently. Whenever I need to do all this in another place, which I will, because I will need all this logic inside the chat view as well. So I can see how all this can become a hook. But I will have also that information in the router, so we'll see. Maybe it's fine this way, who knows. So we just need to hook this up to the button now. So unclick, just accept the project, or the budget, sorry. So if I click accept, cool, this has changed, it's not rendering the button, and budget approved. Not bad. Not bad. Okay, so let's add like some accepted state in here first. Now I think I might create like a like a project state. So if this is null, we're going to render So then if this is false, we can return a rejected state, and if not, an accepted one. Great. I think I should be able also to, I don't know if it will make sense to add here like accepted at a certain date, right? Like right now this budget, which I don't know if I have here the ID. This should have like a some update of that, right? So maybe I can use that. See? So no, not going to bother with that right now. Nah. I might be able to use this loading state, yeah, from the mutation. Yeah, okay. So let's move to reject. So as I was mentioning before, rejecting a budget means that the customer needs to specify why they are rejecting it. So I'm thinking that a model here, which is what we have right now on the chat, it's what will make most sense. But I'm not 100% sure. So something like, I mean, it's pretty easy to build something like this, right? So when hitting reject, I want to... to just like toggle something for now. And hitting reject just like triggers an unopen event. And we can create a reject model that I know that for now, let's just like add like some with this, we might have more than enough now, so... So let's import all this. And I'm just going to add like the reject model in here. Okay. So now I need to check which copies did I have. Over here. Yeah, something like, we're sorry that this budget doesn't fit what you're looking for. Please leave here like some your reasons for rejecting it. So that the carpenter and let's add a text area. I think there's a text area in the chakra project. Yeah. Any options? Yeah. okay, not bad, but the it's at like some stack, some heavier spacing. And then this is not oh yeah, it's rebuilding, so why is the font size not where is this being like why is this in here? Oof. Unimportant. Like, I didn't remember adding that. I swear, I'm innocent. Important. What's wrong with this? Well, let's not go that far. No. Let's remove the importance for now. Okay. So I should be able then like to call reject here. So again, we're going to create and the schema for this, yeah, both things are mandatory, so which means that we will have to do like some validation as well. Which I hate doing. Let's give formic a try. So I can grab my form, which in this case it's going to be the whole mobile content, I guess. And the model body and the footer with come on, it's not that hard. Okay. And I should pass the current error. Values. Hey Andy, how are you today? Didn't see you there. Form validation. Wait, what? Yeah, I mean, I don't know if anyone likes form validation. I think there's nothing I like less. To be honest, I try to always kind of like put it off as much as possible. And in here, it's just like a single field, and the forms that I have at Otter, it's not that like that many or that like big. Still, I hate it. Wait, what? Like values, it's not. Formic. Oh no. Sorry about that. Yeah. I guess like since we've switched from the the days off to be Friday, I need to update the schedule on Twitch. That's a good reminder. I'm experimenting with doing some more streams, like more often, but I'm not sure if I can add again like the Wednesdays ones. I'm trying to do now like Friday afternoon and sometimes Sunday morning, my morning, just like having a coffee and I don't know, it's a good one. I don't know if through the, now that Twitch offers the ability to put official schedule, Ah, nice. And how does that feel to you? I mean, I was rooting for 5 days off from the very beginning, so. Values is not defined. Yeah, I mean, Wednesdays was nice to have like a break in the middle of the week. But at the same time, it was kind of like my day with no meetings at all. Whereas, like, I don't know, like, I tend to have like 2 to 3 hours of meetings every day, sometimes more. So, like, Wednesdays, it was like my most valued time for coding at Buffer. So I'm glad that that's back and that I can actually cut back on some things, but yeah, you win on our end, on one end, and lose on another, so yeah, what can you do? Okay, so Yeah, deep work Wednesday, like, I think it's something that maybe like even like newer hires are not so aware of it, but maybe they are just like going with deep work Wednesday because like other people try to just keep that up, but it's a good one to encourage everyone to try to minimize meetings that day. Yeah, I guess it's one of these things that we just do, and maybe people wonder why, or yeah, it becomes like one thing that no one knows why. It's invalid. I need to change the focus here from the close button to initial focus ref, yeah. Okay, great, and now if I add something, wait, what? What am I missing here? First time I used this library, it was supposed to help me with validation, but I think it's making it harder just for one field. No change. Really? field form. Does this change anything? Oh, no, yeah, we need to add. Oh god. Name, reason. Okay, this looks better now. So now I can do the mutation. Reject budget, not like the loading state here. So I can call this with variables ID. Oh. So let's give this a try. Okay, missing something else. It's not working. Okay, so validation works. Oh, great. Finally. So... okay, good. I need to also refetch the project and close the... close the model and fetch queries. So if I reject this other project, it should close the model as soon as I hit reject and the API call has gone through. And then it should also update the status here. Okay, great. So now I need to add like the reason here on the budget, if there's a reason for rejecting it. And after that, we can do like one more, one more refactoring. So at the model, it's available here and in the chat too. Okay, so the footer only renders when there's something to render, which is good. Okay, so with this, I think I might be able to test in production how it looks with actual budgets shared by users. Project view, it's looking much better here. I think that maybe I'm able to create like that sort of chat preview that I was exploring a few weeks ago and see how that could look like now that I have like all these other things going on here. I was muted. I think that form validation broke me. So I think this starts to look a little bit like a chat, so not too bad. I just want to, yeah, differentiate between... yeah, I think I'm going to start like advertising the streams, like come for the code, stay for the music. So yeah, I just want to be able to differentiate now between like your own messages and the other person's. And yeah, whereas on the big version right now, on the its own page, there's like always the avatar for everyone and everything, like doesn't make any sense that it's showing my name and my avatar. I think it's understood by context, right? So yeah, I think being able to check for the author and the current user, which is the get user by use context. So here written by me, I should align this to the right side, so flex end, and the background it's going to be white. I think I might even just get less messages. They think I gave it a try on a different live stream. Yeah, I think that will feel better right now, as I want to see like more messages, more variety and everything. I'm going to add like some more. I think it would be nice if I can just like parse links as well. I think there's like some linkifier React component somewhere, so I will look for that. But I want to add the avatar when the message author it's not me. Yeah, I think this looks pretty nice. I wonder if it's too wide, but maybe it's that I just need to make things bigger overall. I don't know. So if I make this smaller, cool. So this works, and yeah, and there's like some attachments here that I think would be great to add as some preview. So if there's like message attachment, I'm going to create like just a link right now with with name and maybe an icon. Oof. Nah, not sure. Cool. So, I mean, it's not bad comparing it side to side, the whole like description and everything. I think it feels like more serious in a way. The whole design now, like the newest design, and everything much clearer, right? Definitely, like, this is horrible. I don't know how did I even ship this, but but yeah, like the budget and stuff, like to be able to see them. Definitely, I need to check now with real projects and see how it flows with that information. And then I will do another session where, like, this looks great for carpenters and clients to see. We just need to add like some admin stuff here that, some admin stuff here, right? Like the edit buttons and be able to edit this information if we need to be able to, like assign the carpenter here, upload files, if somebody requests us to do it. Yeah, all that sort of stuff that it's missing in this new design, as well as deciding a proper like human readable project ID. Yeah, I think the ID will be able to replace this, since this is the description right now, just like with some ellipses, like the first like 40 characters, something like that. So yeah, still way to go for deploying this in production, but good enough for starting to play in staging. So let's see what happens. I will need to do also like some, like before I merge that, I think I will need to fix many more things. And well, I think refactoring the chat now that this is ready, I think like moving it to the actual chat will be just a matter of, I don't know, like 20 minutes to apply the changes and then start to mess around with the actual like budget events that are in here too. But yeah, this is cool. I think we can add here like some breadcrumbs as well. So yeah, I've been at it for the last 3 hours or so. So I think it's time for a break, to just like step out of this room that has like no natural light or anything, and yeah, and hang out with my new puppy. So yeah, thanks everyone that joined, or if you're seeing it as a recording, thanks so much for checking it out. Feel free to reach me at all the social media stuff anytime, and yeah, see you in the next session. Have a good one.